Chuck Ray was a successful Anchorage lawyer who loved working in a courtroom setting. But as Channel 2's Austin Baird explains, his passion was thrown into jeopardy just a few years ago. Austin?
Caslin, it's not easy for anyone to change everything about their professional life decades into a career, but that's exactly what Chuck Ray says he had to do. Try to make sense of the words through the constant screeching, the ringing, the sound like an airplane engine. For years, that's what Chuck Ray did. But the tinnitus he suffered grew louder and louder, and deafness won out.
I completely lost my hearing in late 2007.
A difficult transition.
I think I would be less than honest if I said that it wasn't frustrating.
Ray was a successful lawyer then in his 50s. Instead of retiring, he asked a question. How can I make this work so I can stay at work?
I knew that I could try cases, which is what I really enjoy doing.
He still does what he loves, but now at a higher level than ever.
I actually had the chance many years ago to spend about a week in Glen Allen on a case that Chuck Ray was a part of, and I got a chance to see him in action.
Parnell, then a lawyer, was impressed. So when a seat came open on the Superior Court in Bethel in 2012, Governor Parnell picked Ray to fill the vacancy.
He said he's a salt of the earth kind of guy. He understands not only rural communities, but Alaskans.
Ray was a commercial fisherman for a decade all over the state, making him uniquely qualified to serve Alaska's largest judicial district. But there were concerns.
What I found was when I first appeared in front of him, it was remarkable that the hearing went off just like I was before any other judge.
The price tag also raised some eyebrows. Judge Ray requires a specialized court reporter who types 200 words a minute and accurately transcribes everything said in the courtroom. The judge sees the words on a screen. It's expensive, but Parnell says it's worth every dollar to get the right man for the job.
I've treated the selection of judges with great sincerity and seriousness, because these appointments will last much longer than a governor's in office.
Judge Ray says he gives little thought to how he's perceived, focusing instead on the people he serves.
It's a lot of fun, but it's an extraordinary amount of work. Out here in Bethel, I think, in particular.
But he does hope he's measured the same as his colleagues.
If there are issues about the quality of what I do, I hope that they're only the same concerns that people would express about any other trial judge.
There are just 300 court reporters in the nation who are qualified to transcribe proceedings for a deaf judge. They filter in and out of Bethel in two-week increments at a projected cost of $365,000 over the next fiscal year. Caslin?
Wow, that is a story. It's really impressive what he's overcome. Did Judge Ray offer any advice?
Well, Caslin, for people who are hearing impaired, Judge Ray says it's really important just to set their own goals, to not let others say what they can or can't do. And to people who can hear, he says don't be afraid to try and communicate with people who are deaf. It might take some extra work, but it's worth it. Caslin?
All right. Thanks, Austin.